Welcome to the Southern Institute of Technology's academic program, the Certificate in Interior Decor. Over the next 5 weeks, we'll be transforming this flat behind me into a modern masterpiece. With a splash of paint and some new furniture, we will show you how simple it is to redecorate your home. The flat consists of 6 rooms, all of which will be redecorated. This week's challenge is the kitchen. Let's find out some suggestions from our designer.
This week we'll follow through to the kitchen area. It's quite a confined space, so what we want to do there is a very good trick to do is add a little bit of deeper colour possibly into the kitchen cupboards. Now we've got sort of a mauve sort of colour on here now, so we could look down just into something here to match the stainless steel quite nicely in the likes of say a quarter mondo and so on. Now also the walls in here, quite confined with cupboard space, so what we'll do is follow the colour up onto the cupboards, and that way it just ties it all in very nicely. You end up with multiple colours. The condition of the walls here, of course we have a vinyl wallpaper, so that would need to be sealed, and possibly look at a low sheen finish in the likes of say space coat, a low sheen wood based enamel, give us more durability and washability. And also for the cupboards, so we'll head with the wood based enamels. And just say a semi-gloss finish, and that will give you more washability, then a low sheen on the cupboards. And you could do a nice wee bench top on here, on top of the existing vinyl that need to be replaced. Also things in the kitchen to look out for a safety, so obviously fire hazards, that sort of thing. What we have here is a nice fabric drape, nice colour. Catch fire very easy, as maybe already a bit of grease and fat on the curtains as such. So possibly get rid of these here, net curtains, and maybe nice just a blind here, Venetian blind would be ideal, it's a horizontal one, and possibly a stainless steel look to match the bench top, tidal, very modern. Also, practicality of having drapes in the kitchen, washability, so they're very marked here, so a good clean up, could bring them up, but someone has a toaster and so on, toasty pie maker here, could easily catch fire and do a bit of damage, so the insurance will cover that. And other things to look out for is obviously oven doors smacking against kitchen doors, so once again hardware and finish would be required.
Thanks for that, Travis. Now it's off to Rosine to find some paint for the cupboards.
Morning, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Oh, hi. How did you get on with that wall colour you had?
The pavlova looked fantastic. We used it in the lounge, the living and the kitchen.
Oh yeah?
It looks just great. But now we need something for the kitchen cupboards and the cupboards in the living room. So I'm hoping for something a little bit darker just to bring it out a wee bit more.
Okay, so we could look into the it's a neutral range again, but just go into the deeper side of it.
Okay, so this is the same book we used the other day, isn't
it? Yes, it is, yep. Okay, we chose pavlova the other day, wasn't it? It was mm-hmm. the 8th pavlova.
Mm-hmm.
What you could do with it is bring in the deeper shades of it, pavlova.
Okay, yeah.
Or you could go into near these other ones too, like your double T's, Nepas, Mondos, Domals.
Kind of like the depth in this colour here at the top.
Depth in that one?
Mm.
Okay, we'll have to get the bigger fan deck out to show you the different strengths in that one.
That's fine.
Okay, we'll just find those strengths for you. That would probably be fraction dark with your
it would, wouldn't it?
Pavlova. Yep. So you could come down to either the quarter or the eighth.
Okay.
Which would actually look quite nice with that one there.
Okay. That one's a wee bit dull. I probably like this one here a wee bit more.
Yeah, just a wee bit more brown in there, isn't there?
Yep, there is.
So I would suggest to use Lustacryl semi-gloss water-based enamel.
Yep, and why is that?
Okay, I'll just show you where that is. It gives you a nice, good, hard surface to work with. Also, it's a semi-gloss, so it's nice and easy to wipe down thing in a kitchen.
Good.
Okay. So it's just this one here. How much would you be after? Is it a big area?
It's a pretty small area, so what size do they come in?
They come in size 1s and 4s. If it's a small area, we could start with a 1, which they're over here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think we could start with 1 litre and then maybe come back for more if we need it, because it is just the kitchen cupboards.
Yes, well, that would be my suggestion, because you'd, as a deeper colour, it'll be in a base, so you'd have to do probably 1 or 2 ones.
Yep, great, so we've got the colour, this is the right paint here.
Yep, so yep, that's the base I need to use.
Okay, should we get that ready to go then?
Sweet as.
Thank you.
Thank you.
When painting the kitchen and changing the colour scheme, what are some of the important style factors we need to consider?
Style, depends on the situation you're in. Appliances, may not be able to afford to modernise them too much, so keep it pretty practical. Once again, you haven't got much wall space generally because it is a kitchen, you've got cupboards on the wall and so on. So things to look at, serviceability, durability, especially on the cupboards themselves, the main factors to really look out for. And generally, your kitchen's smaller windows above the sink and so on, so light's the main factor.
John, are there special types of paints that you have to use in the kitchen?
Yep, basically something that's washable, so semi-gloss or a full gloss. Anything, a lot of the wash and wear paints and that, I mean, it's, as long as it's serviceable. Obviously you want a semi-gloss on the ceiling for if you're cooking with anything greasy and fats or anything else, and it's just a build up over time with fumes on the ceiling bits pieces.
Yep. But just on these walls here, are you just using the same paint as
we're
in the
using lounge? The same paint at the moment, because it's not too bad. There's a lot of ventilation here, a lot of windows, and so it's not really an issue here.
Yep. What colours are important to help keep the kitchen looking clean? You wouldn't want to have a white wall or anything like that.
Depends on the finish that you want. You could use possibly very light colours. It depends on the product you'd use. Washability is a main factor in the kitchen. Steam-wise, it can affect the paint, so water-based enamels are ideal. Also, cupboard-wise, if you go light cupboards and you just paint them and so on, it's nice to have a little bit depth of colour in the cupboards. Reason why, your stains, that sort of thing. Easily washable as well.
Paul, what is wet edging?
When you keep a wet edge on your paintwork, it's basically you're working into the wet surface. As you can see, John's cutting up the side of the door, and he'll work in towards that. Keeping a wet edge, so you should always be working keeping a wet edge, that way your paint's not drying out, so you're not getting any inconsistencies in your finish.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so as you can see, he takes it up and working back into his wet edge. Okay, he'll cut in and then he finishes off by working back into his wet edge. Cut in and then he'll finish that off by laying it off into his wet edge.
How can the colours of a kitchen affect the mood?
The mood? It's a sort of working area anyway. So you get white appliances, it's nice and stark with those sort of areas. Maybe you have a stainless steel bench top sort of thing. So colour-wise, keep it nice and fresh, clean, and just put some nice handles on the cupboards as well, can work really well.
John, the kitchen's quite a small area. What measures can you take to help the ventilation and the fumes off the paint?
Ventilation? Open some windows and get a fan blowing on cold air just to get the air circulating. Onions is a good thing. If you're using solvent based paints and that, onions is sort of like some old wives' tale, but it definitely works.
Yep.
But it takes a lot of it out of the air. I mean, a lot of the coloured paints and that, if you leave onions cut up, you can actually see it absorbs some of the fumes and actually discolours it.
And without doing things like that, how long can fumes hang around in a room for?
If it's in a confined space, there's no airflow days, so it stays quite stale and the smell sort of lingers. But a lot of the water-based paints are sort of, this paint dispersion pretty quick.
And are the fumes quite bad for humans?
No, most of the paints are fairly good. It's irritating, but some of the solvent-based ones, but a lot of the acrylics and that, there's no real risk, no health risk.
Can they give you headaches or anything?
Some of the sort of strong ammonia smell, they can. Everyone's susceptible, everyone's different. The tolerances and that to some of the smells, but overall it's not too bad. It's a bit of an ammonia smell, but some of them are stronger than others.
Como la semilla.
Is it important to just stick to a couple of colours so it's not such a busy place with all the appliances?
Definitely. Some of the things you have to look at is you get your appliances, which are possibly white, stainless steel bench, opposing benches, so you end up with quite a few colours in there. So basically keep it nice and light on the walls, maybe a little bit deeper on the cupboards, tie it all in without looking out of place.
So Paul, you're using an environmental choice paint today. Can you just tell me about that?
Basically what it is designed to do is to basically look after the environment, look after to us who are using it, and the environment in general. So when you're cleaning out materials, you're no longer washing them out in heavy chemical solvents, which obviously, if you think back to the old days with the lead-based paints, you know, lead's quite a poisonous, quite a toxic material. That's no longer used in paints. Well, the water-based paints are basically designed to be cleaned out in water, thinned down in water, obviously a lot safer, a lot healthier for everybody involved. So you'll find most of the major paint companies now are all striving to basically save the planet and save our little whales.
Yep, and what brand are you using today?
Today we're using Resene, which is quite a leader in paint technologies.
And what about following trends in the kitchen?
Once again, the colours, probably the main ones are on the cupboards themselves, but trends wise, you can always put a nice splash background in the kitchen. It can work quite well.
And do colour schemes change for larger and smaller kitchens?
Yeah, they certainly do. Depends if you've got overhead cupboards and so on, so that can sort of divide a room. If they can be easily removed, it's ideal. If you're doing up a kitchen on a budget as well, you can tie in like a living area, dining area sort of thing, so lots of space. So.
Doing the kitchen cupboards, we put a sand them down, give them a coat of acrylic primer undercoat, and it'll have two top coats now of water-based enamel, which is pretty hardy and it should withstand all the opening and shutting of doors and any spillages running on them. Yeah, just using a wee mini roller to put on initially, and also on the doors, they're small enough just to brush.
Should you have colour schemes that match like the curtains and the bench top and the flooring?
Well, things you have to look at in the kitchen is hazards, that sort of thing. So if you have curtains above a sink, around the range hood, that sort of thing, needs to catch fire. So a nice contemporary blind, Venetian blind, can look quite smart in there. So nice, clean, sharp colours.
Great. And what tips do you have for anyone who's wanting to do up the kitchen?
Kitchen? Whether it be an old veneer kitchen or standard decorative paint, look at durability options and just keep it nice and practical. Nice and clean, sharp colours is always best.
Okay, basically what I'm doing here, as you can see, is just undercoating the entrance door to the kitchen. Just giving it a good sand down, a bit of a dust down, and now putting a coat of primer undercoat on it so John can follow behind when it's dry with his top coat of enamel. We're using the water-based enamel. Good and hard wearing, sustains the knocks. Finger marks, easily wiped off. If you were to use the likes of the paint that we put on the walls, you would find that would mark quite easily. Attracts a lot, you know, your finger marks, etc., etc., the oils out of your hands. So if you use a good enamel, it'll help prevent that. So I'm just basically putting it on and then just laying it off.
So there's lots of things going on inside in the kitchen as the final touches are being put in place. But while that's all happening, I've got a wee project underway here. I've collected a series of cups from a second-hand shop, which I am going to plant some cacti in. First, I'm going to paint them, so let's get started. I've chosen some quite earthy colours to paint the cups, as our colours are quite natural and neutral inside, so I don't want them to stand out too much, but just to fit in nicely and look really great. Okay, so the first coat is dry on the cups now, so I'm going to start applying the second coat. I'm hoping I'll only have to do two coats, just so it's going to be a bit quicker. Now I've chosen these three cups here as my three favourites, basically because I really like the shape, and I also think that the big opening hole at the top of them here is going to be the best to fit in my three cacti just below. So I'll get started. Now I don't have any gardening gloves, so I'm actually going to pick the cacti up with a rubbish bag just so I don't prick myself, which I probably will anyway because they are such strong little things. That's the third and final one put in its place, and don't they look fantastic? I'm quite happy with those.
Yeah.
that's the final touches for the kitchen, and doesn't it look great? Now let's find out what our expert thinks. Close to you, I can't breathe.
Good afternoon, Nora. How are you?
Hello, Travis. How are you today?
Very good, very good. Nice new kitchen here, we see.
Yes, it's looking fantastic, isn't it?
Nice and open. It's good. I like what you've done here with the removing of the cabinets.
Yep.
It's got a really nice colour as well. Nice feel to the kitchen.
It does. Without that big cabinet there, it's so much more open, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's also modernised the vinyl on here on the bench top. It's looking really good.
Yeah, the vinyl has worked out quite nice. It's worked in really well with the colour of the cupboards. I think the colour of the cupboards is fantastic too.
Yeah, so see, it's gone from that sort of purple colour to actually this colour, so it's darkened it up, modernised it quite a lot, and also played a bit of touch up here, so get the flow from the dining area through to the kitchen, ties it on very nicely.
And what do you think about some of the other things we've brought into the kitchen?
The lighting, yep, different light shades there, nice and effective. Also the drapes, once again, nice and light, nice and clean appearance. So. Looking good.
And what about my wee project in the corner over here?
Oh, I wouldn't want to pick them up, but no. They're very colourful, but it's just simple things like that you can actually add a bit of colour into it. Maybe a fruit bowl into the corner like you have here as well, so it's looking very good.
Fantastic. Well, I'm glad that you're happy with the kitchen, and thank you so much for your advice.
No problem, once again.
Thanks for joining us in the kitchen today. I hope you picked up some useful tips. If you would like more information on the certificate in interior decor, please call 0800 SIT to learn. Be sure to join us next week when we tackle the bedrooms. See you then.